back.
Hey. So, Highlander, UGC, right? I want to give a shout out to May and Yumi from Quail Noises. I was about to say Bird Noises. Honestly, without them right now, we wouldn't be watching this cast. So, some dedication. They are starting late. And also we could get into watching this. So I really appreciate them helping us out here. And if you guys are stopping by or watching, you know, I appreciate you here too. With me again is Mime. Hello again, Mime.
Hey, again.
And we're ready. We're hopefully going to be ready to go in just a little bit here. I'm going to take a look at our...
Our chat is a bunch of Doge, I don't know what they call those, all text.
Yeah, I don't know what to call it either. The name escapes me. So we're gonna just take a quick look at the roster. Looks like, I didn't alias out Rue here, so he's gonna show up as a hot dog. Yum, I like hot dogs, at least for the time being. But, anyway.
I have him aliased, so I'm in good shape.
You are a smart, smart man. But anyway, we're gonna be watching this game finally take place. And like I said, thanks a lot to Yumi and May. So, you wanna go down the roster here real quick for the Quail Noises side?
Sure. On Scout is Yumi, Sai is playing Soldier, Bubs on Pyro, May on Demo, Rue on Heavy, Just on Engie, Vol on Medic, Cav2019 on Sniper, and Pomp on Spy.
Alright. And over on the Appel side, Appel, as they prefer to be known as, we're gonna be seeing BFF Forever on Scout, Bunny on Soldier, American on Pyro, Gilder on Heavy, Gilder on Demo, Viper on Heavy, Knock on Engineer, Brule on Medic, Smiles, also known as Smile Z on Sniper, and Jaden on Spy. Pretty cool stuff. I'm really excited to watch this go down. I really think that it has the potential to be a really good game, despite some people believing it might be a little too quick for our taste, but I think it has the potential. So, I don't think we ever specifically, sorry if I cut you off there, but specifically put out our predictions, did we?
I think we did towards the end, but I think we both predicted 2-0 in favor of Quails.
Yeah, it's unfortunately looking that way. I shouldn't say unfortunately. I don't want to diminish, how good Quails has been. That's not my my goal here. I just like to see games take a while. I don't know. Maybe I'm a glutton for punishment.
As I was going to say, chat wants to know, when do you plan on doing a co-cast with Slick Penny?
She hasn't contacted me. So, usually with people of her elite stature, I prefer not to bother them because I feel like they probably get, a lot of harassment, I guess, from players looking to. So, you know, it's Silk, I'm out here, add me on Steam, that's Vox with 10 X's, and you can just pop in here and anytime I'll cast with you. Mime, how about you? When are you gonna do it?
Well, I'm ending my casting, or postponing my casting career for this season, upcoming season.
That's right. Don't remind me.
It's gonna have to wait.
Don't remind me. Am I right, guys?
Oh, that's a good one.
You're gonna have to put that in your back pocket for later. But yeah, Mime is going to be playing TF2. I didn't know people still did that. I thought they were only casters, honestly. But, It looks like we've got a 9v8 in the server. We're waiting on one more player for the Apple side, and it looks like we're waiting on their demo, Gilder Glider, to come back.
Who is running the Iron Bummer? Is that Mate?
Yeah. Is it Mate?
Yeah,
Mate's got that Iron Bomber. That's honestly a little scary. I wonder if we're gonna be seeing that. But anyway, I feel like I have to go over some of the things we already went over, just because we restarted the cast. But I mean, it's just the culmination of a season, of a near perfect season here by Quail Noises. As mentioned earlier, they lost their first match of the season. That was against the team formerly known as the Syndicate Reborn on Upward. And an upset of sorts. I think at that time, though, they were more evenly matched teams. I think a lot of people were expecting it to go to Quail Noises, but this was back when the Syndicate Reborn was supposed to be, you know, one of the top three teams before all their roster troubles, and they ended up losing 0-2, and there's been speculation about the match, and, you know, not to get into it or anything, but they've been perfect ever since. They've just kept winning and kept winning and kept winning. So here they are in the grand finals. Not really a shock or surprise, I'd say, for most people to see them here. And in terms of Appel, they've had a quite a different road in terms of they lost their first game. They brought it back, and they probably won about 4 or 5 in a row, I'd like to say, before... I think they ended with a 6-2, is that right?
Or that sounds right. 5-3, actually.
5-3, that's right, yeah. Because they ended up losing to Quail Noises in Week 8. That's what got them their third loss. And I mean, an overall really solid season, and they got knocked down to the lower bracket. Oh, I think we're going live.
I believe we're.
Alrighty, so I'm going to be watching May here on our first rollout as we get live on the grand finals of UGC Gold here, guys. So May is still running that Iron Bomber, going to put some damage out. Going to go down pretty low, though, so Glider doing a good job of preventing May from getting really aggressive. But here we go. May's actually going to pick one up, but going down, going to be Yimmy and May. Jaden's going to get that backstab, so he's got to be careful. Taking a look at the point again. Oh, Yimmy, that was a spy dead ring, but Smiles is going to pick up the frag either way. Sai's jumping in, trying to wreak some havoc on the battlements. But it looks like this first mid is going to go to Quail Noises. Still a good, I mean, some good positioning here by Apple, but it looks like they just don't have the players to keep contesting.
If Apple hadn't lost Glider towards the end of that mid fight, they may have been able to actually win it, but... You know, Glider going down is a pretty big deal, so...
Right. I mean, especially on Lakeside, too. Kev's going to take the better Smiles that time, but any time your demo goes down, it can just be absolutely crushing, because that damage that you can put forward on the point, the spam you can put over those stairs is just huge. Glider is going to get a stick or two onto Vol, take him down about half health. He's regening now, but it looks like the Uber is going to get used. Yimmy pushing forward with Bub, so they might not get anything out of this. Brulé is going to use her Uber, however. Maybe with a chance to cap the point here would be Apple. Glider trying to get some damage onto Vol. Not really getting anything just yet, but just kind of doing his best. But Quenlis is going to collapse onto the point. Kev on a 4k now after taking out Smiles yet again.
May also caught Brulé while she was trying to back out from the point, so that's going to buy them some more time to hold it.
Bunny going to deal with Pomp there, but I mean, the point is pretty well capped right now. We've got Vol sitting at about 75%, so We just gotta worry about that Uber they're gonna have pretty soon. Someone's gonna make the play, because I don't think Vol has actually died just yet this round. And Smile's gonna go down again, but this time to Psy, so a good pick, good play by him there. They're doing a good job so far, Quilnos, is focusing down Smiles, because they know just how dangerous of a player he can be. The Uber is gonna come out by Quilnos, but not in time to save the point, in fact. So they should be able to take it back here, but... that's not what you want out of your Uber. You want to be able to block the point and hopefully be able to retain it, but they're going to give some time here to Apple, which probably going to go back to Quail Noise's heights, because it's just Gilder there, Glider.
Bradley almost has her Uber, though, so I think they're going to recap it right now.
Yeah, it's kind of rough here for Apple. Oh, Glider going down to about 16 health before that Uber gets used, but it's kind of rough if they had gotten that Uber a little bit sooner, which obviously is not something that you can really control, but they could have been able to block the point and never have to lose it, you know, that 15 seconds or so. Can actually turn into 30 seconds when you think about it. And it's just one of those things.
I don't know if you've been watching Bathhouse much at all, but, Quail Noises really hasn't put much of anything in it the entire time, and I think Apple's about to take advantage of that right now, so they gotta hold set up.
Yeah, pretty good chance. They have their entire combo. Smiles is in there too. He goes for the shot onto Psy, and I think actually managed to hit him. So a very impressive shot there, but Uber is gonna get used out. May is just gonna collapse onto Brulé, take her out. So although they had the positioning in Bathhouse, I just with that Uber coming in and with May's DM just not able to prevent their medic from going down. Jaden is gonna pick up a frag there on the May, but going down to Psy, he's gonna kind of find him there in the Bathhouse. Kev with a chance maybe to pick something up, gets a headshot into Bunny, not able to take him down.
It's tough because you want to hold close to the point, but holding in Bathhouse puts you in so many choke points that it's almost risky to hold there. And that made it hard for Relay to back out and the rest of the combo to back out.
Pomp getting a rare backstab. I say rare because he's known as a gun spy, but in their game against Papa's Peddlers, he switched it up a lot. Jaden getting yet another frag, but it's definitely scary to think of Pomp using his knife as well as the Ambi. We got an Uber used yet again here by Vol, so a decent Uber. They don't manage to pick up Brulé, but with 10 seconds left, Apple's got to get onto this point and figure something out. Because unless they can get some serious overtime, Brulé's not going to have her Uber to contest here. It is actually going to come forward, but no one's getting on the point still. Finally, someone gets in, but Glider is going to go down here. Minute 50 remaining on the clock for Apple, so it's going to be really difficult for them to contest if they do get the point. Smile is going to take out Vol, which is a huge pick for them there. It might start a comeback. But a lot of players of Quail Noises right now aggressing onto the point.
And Yimmy is behind them with, I don't know, he had like 2 HP and he's now on a 3k.
But that is going to be the round, the taunt on the point there by Yimmy. So the first round of our grand finals gonna go to Quail Noises. Probably relatively unsurprising, I guess, that they would come out first, but definitely not a bad round there by Apple. I say if they just tighten things up a little bit, maybe have a better mid, they have a good chance of taking a round here off of Quail Noises. Glider is going to go down here to Kev, however, so that probably is going to spell the mid for them there without their demo, unless they can figure out something. But there goes Vipa, so Pomp is chasing a little bit here onto Brulé. Maybe
Sire's
might be able to...
also put behind, he's at the spawn. I don't know if he knows Brulé is there, but he might be able to get a pick on Brulé right now.
He jumps in, Brulé is going to... Oh,
wow. Oh.
Unfortunate for Brulé. Like I admire the chance or the attempt to surf there, but Psy not fooled, able to get an air shot, a mini air shot, I'll call it. But he manages it and gets to pick off the med for it. Jaden with a chance, he's behind right now. He's got to be careful because I think Bubs that spy sense is tingling just a little bit. But he has a chance here to maybe pick up Vol. Oh, but there gets the Uber used there out of Vol. Maybe if Jaden can stay alive, unless he actually did just go down to that mini, maybe with a chance to clean up afterwards. But the
coming in, he might get a stab here. I don't know.
Oh, he goes in, not able to pick it up. Apple, even though on the losing side of the Uber, are going to manage to take up onto the point. Brulé is close to hers, so they've just got to kind of rally around and make sure that Brulé stays alive here, because at least they will have an Uber to contest with whenever, inevitably, Quenlusis comes pushing back. Yimmy going to get onto point and just meat shot. Vipa right away going in for the stab. There was Jaden, and it says a lot there too how Yimmy was able to walk out of that fight with 3 health. It's just, you know, that's one of those things that's gonna be, you need to fix when you're playing against a team at this level.
See, I almost feel like Apple should have maybe used into Quillnoses right there. They had a pretty good advantage. They had 25% on them, and they kind of just let Quills walk up to the point and get the ground they needed before they even capped or used their Uber.
Right, maybe post your spy from behind. Looks like point's going to go back to Quillnoses, but, you know, get a call on the meta. Kev is going to take out Brulé, so that's going to put a hefty add into Quillnoses' pocket. But, yeah, get a call on the medic, send some people forward, bring your scout in on the Uber, and you should be able to make a good play there. So maybe some more aggression out of Apple here could really, really change the tides of this game.
I don't know what BFF is doing, but he is behind Quillnoses. He's gone back now, but he was at their spawn.
Alert. The control point has been contested.
And we are just waiting on a pick. Oh no, did I just move away from Pomp? He was about to look like drop onto something there. Not able to pick anything up on that one. Yimmy is going to go down, but a few picks, Gilder or Glider. And Jaden are going to be down. 60 seconds remaining as we take a look, kind of quick little overview of what we got going on at the point. I love when the STV camera actually captures something pretty good. BFF Forever going to try to get on point, but not going to be able to pick anything up. Glider's going to be pushing forward, maybe able to get the frag, not able to pick it up just yet onto Just. Vipa's going to go down, so is Bunny. So decimated are the numbers here for Apple. They do manage to cap up on the point, take it away from Quillnoses, but will it be enough? Brulé's going to use her Uber, doesn't have too much to use it on, so she's going to push people back here with American, but the one thing they got to look out for is Vol is going to be up on Uber in just a few seconds, and getting point back right now is Quillnoses.
Smiles is on bats right now. He's getting quite a few headshots right now. He might be able to pick a combo member if he's careful enough.
Well, right now, any play on any player is going to be huge for... Oh, no, as I say that, May just gets 3 frags, takes out Glider, takes out Brulé. Vipa goes down, there goes Smiles. Vol did use his Uber in that exchange, but this might spell this round as well for the Quillnoses crew. Kev now on a 5k after taking out Knock the NG for Apple, and we're going to have our 2-0. So remember, in regards to what's going on here, if Quillnoses takes this round, this map is over, because they only play one half of each map. So we are going to be moving on to our third and possibly final round. I actually took a look at the snipers on this mid. Looks like they haven't really found much. Kev is keeping an eye out for Smiles. But not too much going on there. And we really haven't seen a huge trade of points. Smiles is actually going to take out Pomp. Root there. Pomp is down. May is going to take out Vipa. So no heavies for either team. Smiles looks like he's charging up a shot. Maybe might be able to take out Psy here. It's going to be tough, but Bunny is going to get in and save his dear fellow sniper. So really smart play by him there, and good job by Smiles calling out when he felt the pressure.
The entire flank for Quails is down right now, though, so and we see the Uber exchange as well.
Yeah, not too much coming out of it for Apple right now. Quillnoses just has such strong presence on the point and has a lot of time capped up on it. Smiles now on a 4k after taking out Just. So heating up just a little bit, manages to get a body shot onto May. but should be able to recover just fine, getting heals from his medic. We're going to see some great spam by Mei over the point. They got to be careful that going down. Smiles is finally going to die, and there goes Glider as well to, looks like to Mei, or to, I think Kev maybe hit that headshot with Mei assisting, but there goes the point. Finally, the point cap. That was still technically a mid-fight there.
American, towards the end of that mid-fight, he kind of just walked around the other side where Quonizas wasn't watching. He got Sai and almost killed Ryu. It picked up a couple frags.
Cheeky pyro plays, man. We're taking a look at Pomf. Might be able to snag something here. Hanging out above the enemy combo. We have an Uber exchange and probably about to take place. It looks like Pomf is just calling. He's gonna focus down on Smiles instead. Maybe still with a chance to drop the Uber, but no, we're gonna get the exchange onto the point. Kev getting the better of Smiles. Looks like some flashing for either team, so pretty relatively even Ubers. Mei gonna go down pretty low, is actually gonna go down to American, so with Pomp coming in and actually butter knifing Brulé, that could be really huge to turn the tide of this, but only three members remaining here for Quailnoises. They haven't been able to get Vol like all game though. Vol has probably only died once or twice, I'd have to guess.
I think once, but I think that was the right move by Quailnoises. Even though they have, you know, heal advantage, they were down a few numbers and they already have advantage on the time, so they can just push back and recap.
Mei already aggressing point just slightly, putting some sticks, feeling out what could be going on. And maybe we'll see something similar of what they've been doing. Just send their flank forward. Smiles taking out Kev there. If they can get Yimmy and Sai forward with Mei spamming that damage. Actually, here is the Uber being used. American doing a good job so far of keeping it back. It is going to keep the majority of Apple alive, but the main casualty there was going to be Brulé. But as I said that, chasing frags to a... was that chasing frags, or did everyone in Apple just stay in? I gotta say, I didn't catch that specifically.
I think it was chasing frags, but Bubs followed Glider all the way to main and ended up catching the frag. So, you know, that's worth it.
Yeah, definitely something that I feel Quailnoises just feels like they can get away with right now. Their DM is so superior, and that's not a knock against Apple, but they're superior to everyone in gold, so... looks like Mei is going to snag a pick onto Glider here. A lot of time going down on the point, so Apple showing some good aggression, a good dry push here, even though they're down in their Uber ad. They are going to manage to take point. They only trade a few frags for it as well. Only BFF and American, I think they had a couple respawns too, but not a bad take of the point. The Uber did get used out of Vol here, but Brulé is going to stay alive at least for the time being. They got to be careful not to let their medic die, because if they can get forward, they might have a chance to put some good time in there. Oh, Glider getting the nice pipe onto Sai. So pretty sick play by him there. Saving his medic as well. So twofold that pick is going to be 100% for the Uber, and we might see leading forward on the charge right now is American and Glider here for Apple with the Uber. May's down, actually. Smile's going to take down Mei, so very, very key pick. Vol looks like he should be able to kite. I would like to see someone from Apple chase forward. Maybe BFF can run in, or maybe if Jaden was in a position, but it looks like Vol is going to escape. He's probably down to about 50 health, but he's regenning just fine now. He's going to be close to his Uber at 90%.
And he almost died there, but he got a very nice surf out with 40 HP.
And it just goes to show, he's so difficult to kill, and they play him very well, because although it's a passive play in terms of getting out, he stays alive. So I'd argue against myself, not passive, but you know, he's quick to back out, but it's helping out his team in the long run. And if Apple wants to stand a chance, they probably needed to try to focus him a little bit more and maybe send their scout forward in on that Uber.
That's a rare sight. Sai died to the afterburner from the Debrusen. I don't think I've seen that happen in a very long time.
He must have been really low down on the health. I think I'm just really bad with my health management, but I die all the time. I'm so bad. Anyway, we're seeing the fight on point. Apple knows what's at stake here. They're committing all their bodies. Brulé's at a 10% disadvantage, but hopefully won't mean too much as we see the fight on the point go down, and it looks like... Well, we can safely assume that Quail Noise has walked away with the victory there.
I'm just going to make that assumption up to the score.
Yeah, so it looks like we got a 3-0 for Quail Noise. The only reason I'm a little peeved is I know that this is going to happen too for Steel, and if we move into Gully Wash, we're going to see the same thing happen.
Looking at the damage, May almost doubled the damage of the next top damage, 744 DPM.
That's not right. I mean, that's just legal. I think there might be some kind of law against that. Oh.
The closest was Collider 471.
May. May just apologized in chat, so we're all okay. We're all okay.
Wow.
So, it looks like that won't happen again to us, guys. So, that's the good thing. That's what we gotta take away from this. So, why don't we go ahead and let me get these logs up for you guys. Alright, so here are our fancy logs. Oh my god, yeah. So, I mean, Smiles did what he could to try to keep up there. You could see May with 27, Kev with 25, Smiles with 24, so really kind of pushing far ahead from a lot of the other players on his team. Vipa is going to be the next one up in terms of frags, and it's going to be half contribution of Smiles, and as Mai mentioned, that absurd damage there from May. 744 DPM without a single crits. So Vol, as Spring Rose is feeding me some good information here too in the chat, but Vol is going to die only once compared to Brulé's 10, and I don't think that's as much, like, that's not a fault of Brulé's. I think maybe trying to play a little bit more passive is—it's—it's a hard position to be in. I shouldn't pretend that I'm the expert on this, but it's tough when you're the medic because you want to stay in, you want to be healing your team, and you know that you need to be playing aggressive. But at the same time, when you keep dying, there's that little voice in the back of your head that says, you know, I need to protect. Vol again with near immaculate stats, no drops, one death, 20 assists. 14 charges and 1,400 heals per minute. It's just brilliant. May is gonna walk away with the most frags on the medic there with 4, and Kev with 3, Sai with 2, and you see Smiles there, the lone frag onto Ball, and Smiles actually taking the sniper v sniper 6v5. I mean, it's kind of like a subscript, you know, winning the SVS, just like lightly subtitled. Winning one more exchange really isn't a huge, huge tell of that, but anything else that you're seeing? Yeah.
This isn't really, I don't know, important, but I find it funny the ratings that your little plugin gives players.
Right?
I don't know how accurate they are.
Well, I think, not to go too far off topic, but depending on if your profile is private, it will not be able to figure out how good you are, and I think it caps gold players at 4 stars. So it's a little, it isn't based on their log performance, I should say that.
I feel like May is a little bit better than a 3-star demo, but maybe I'm wrong.
Well, it's based off of, so May, since May is in gold, starts off with an automatic 3 stars, and if May didn't have a private profile, he would be 4, because of the amount of hours. Anyway, it's called TF2 Stars. It's a neat little plugin. It's not really It's just, yeah, it's just neat to have. But a lot of the players in Quail Noises have private profiles, and I think it makes maybe kind of changes that a little bit. But Mime, taking me off on tangents. What are you doing to me, man? So, I mean, just in time, we are going live here on Steel. Now, we have 60 seconds, actually, until the game starts, and I just want to make a quick mention, too. Lakeside was the map choice of Quail Noises, so pretty unsurprising that they're going to walk away with the victory there. But Steel was Apple's choice, and I remember talking to some players before, you know, not any members with Apple, I don't think, but just, you know, gamers. Thinking Steel might be the best choice for them, but at the same time, you know, what map can you choose against Quail Noises? They've railed you on stopwatch maps. Their DM is so good, which makes Koth maps near impossible. I almost, if I'm Apple, want to go Gully Wash twice, but then if you go Gully Wash twice, you have a bunch of Sixes players playing the... playing Gully Wash. So we are gonna get ready to go live here on our first round. Take a look at Smiles. I think Apple here, if they need to come out and set like a sub 7 time just to have a chance. It's sad to think about that, but you know, if they really want a shot here, they're gonna have to set. I mean, obviously, the faster the better. If they can set 5, they're putting themselves in a great position. But more realistically, probably around 6 or half 7 is going to be where they most likely end up. May getting a little aggressive with those sticky bombs. Might actually peek Smile's sight line here. But actually, he's being very, very careful with his peeks. He's staggering them out. He's not being too predictable. Pomf and American are going to trade positions. Actually, Viper's going to go down. But Bunny is going to clean up on Yimmy and Pomf. So some good picks over on the A side. Maybe a chance to put some pressure onto E here. Smiles did go down to May's stickies. So Kev now in a really great position to get forward. The one thing that you get to look forward to if you're on Apple is you know that Kev is there. There goes Viper yet again. Smile's going to take out May, though. This could be a chance to pick, but no. Kev's going to take out Glider, getting a little bit too aggressive without his medic. And I think that's a misplay, personally.
Honestly, if I were Apple, I would have just gone for A from the very beginning. Because when you sent your flank through there, you saw that it was just Yimmy, and you knew that Pomp was lurking around somewhere, and that was about it. They actually have no resources dedicated to you right now, so that's what I would have done.
But. Yeah, I mean, it looks like Brulee does want to get forward. They know Kev is down. Brulee gets forced on her Uber. So this is going to be a pretty tough one here for Apple. Getting pushed back really hard is Brulee, trying to save her demo, but lost cause trying to get him out. And just dominant right now, Quail Noises. I think their best opportunity was when they took out May, but they weren't able to capitalize with Glider being a little bit too far forward as compared with the rest of his team.
I don't know what you would do right now if you're Apple. Like, you don't want to wait too long because they're probably looking at a 4-minute time right now. Yeah, assuming they got a cap right now.
The clock is slowly ticking. They did put a little pressure onto E, but BFF is going to go down. There's ringing out a headshot there with Smiles, but onto Just, but he's not going to be able to get it. Jaden actually gets a pick onto May, but yet again, Glider is going to go down. So the demo's trade, and it's just... I mean, this time I didn't get to see if Glider was out, like, mispositioned. Just goes down to Smiles, so no NG now, and the sentry's going to go down. I mean, Apple's just eventually got to go for broke. I know Brulee doesn't have her Uber, but there is... actually, there's the Uber out of Quail Noises as I say that, so maybe not going to... Too good. Glider is going to go down yet again. Brulee at 95.
At what point do you say this isn't working? We need to try something different. I think this is the third push that Apple's tried to do on the B, and it's still not working out for them.
Yeah.
I think maybe you should have your flank rotate over, I don't know.
I mean, their best chance here, and it's easier for us to see because we know the exact Uber percentages. Nice shot by Smiles onto Kev there, but we know the Uber percentages, obviously, but pressure onto Eve right now, forcing the combo to fight, and then baiting him into an Uber fight would have been huge, would have been a great play there, but looks like they are going to expend their Uber to take B. Hopefully should be able to walk away with it, but here is Vol's Uber and May, as we have seen the damage that May can put out, should be able to get something done with this. BFF is going to be on the enemy medic. There is Bunny in BFF, though, cleaning up, going to take out Rue, Vol, and May with that. Trying to pick up on Just as well, not able to just yet. Looks like might be able to escape. Kev going to take out Smiles, but... Vol has already died as many times as he did in that entire Lakeside game.
Bunny was doing very well, apparently. He was on an 8 or a 9k.
Yeah, Bunny is right now holding together what little remains of the Apple chances. And they're still going for B. I get the hesitation that you don't know if you can DM them hard enough to go for the AE push. And they've committed a few bodies, but they haven't done a full team push there. And I think at this point, you gotta go for something because Quail Noises is not going to... I think we're at a 6.5 minute time, right? Did you start with 10 minutes?
I can't see my timer, actually, because I'm still using Bill Watterson's HUD.
Oh my god, but... I hate Bill Watterson, honestly.
Are you at a pause?
I am at a pause. We are okay. Paused. So, I mean, maybe this is a pause for Apple to figure out what they need to do. I mean, I can only really speculate how their mumble is feeling right now, because a little defeated, probably. But they've been kind of just trying to jam a square peg in a... Wait, what is it? A round peg in a square hole? Or a round... Or a square peg in a round hole?
Close enough.
Yeah. They're trying... It feels like they're trying to jam a square peg in a round hole here. And it's just not working out. And I don't want to sound too critical. Because obviously, from what we can see in our bird's eye view... And I can see all 18 players and the Uber charges, but Apple definitely needs to figure out something, because as we talk, like, their chances are just slowly ticking away. We're probably at a solid 6 minutes at this point, you know. I will. So one thing to note too, when we come out of the pause, we're gonna see some glitchy. Some glitchy behavior, if you are unaware. Some weird player models and the player information on the HUD on the left side is going to be a little wonky. We should be able to get the timer updated with a quick HUD reload scheme. But
while we're waiting, I'd like to call attention to Rue's beautiful heavy loadout. It's, I don't know.
Wow.
It's a weird looking.
I mean, that's just... That's art, people. That's art in the form of hats. What beard is that he's wearing?
So I used to know what it's called. It's from the end of the line update.
Oh, alright, we're going live. Staring at Rue's beautiful face. Gonna hit that quick HUD reload scheme. So we're gonna have 3.5 minutes left at this point. It looks like Point's being edged. E is being edged right now by BFF. American Glider. It looks like they finally have committed most of their bodies. Brule is on her way. Kev is gonna take out Viper, though. He's sniping from the back spawn. But not putting too much time on Point just yet. Glider trying his best to keep people out in this BEC connector. Rue coming out. It's such a tough position to be in trying to push this, but probably going to work out for Quail Noises in the end. Relay's at 100% though, so maybe it looks like she did get out, regroup with her players and figure out another way to push this. But you kind of maybe got to try to go with a dual push, and it's so tough because when they're taking these fights, they're just out getting out DM really, really hard. But there goes Yimmy, gonna take a glider. BFF jumping up on the point again. American getting forward, getting sniped by Kev. Did not think that was gonna be the thing that killed him on that suicide play. Viper gonna go down here to Rue.
Relay's stuck in lobby right now, full Uber. She doesn't have anyone to heal. Pomp is right around the corner, or Just and a couple other players.
Oh, she gets forced out of the Uber. She's running. She's gonna find glider, but that means that they gotta be careful for the rest of the members of Quail Noises. Brulee gets stuck on the door. She's trying her best to kite. May, actually, the rare time that you see May not hit one of his pipes or sticks, but Brulee is eventually gonna go down to a Yimmy at the end of it. BFF gonna take out Just, maybe grab up on this pack, but a minute and a half remaining. B is halfway capped right now for the Apple crew. But now, this I'm making sure that I'm understanding correctly. 23 seconds to cap A. If Apple can't cap B, which it looks like they're going to, it would have just been 23 seconds. If they cap A in less than 23 seconds, the game would have been over. But they do cap B. We're already at 8 minutes with just having B capped. So they're going to have to go for an ABE push. There's no time to go for C. But it looks like they are going to commit some bodies over there. Just like, looks like American, Jaden, and... did Smiles just take out Sly with the Gerardi Bushwacka?
I watched it happen. Poor guy.
BFF put some great time onto E here. I mean, Apple is just going the safe route right now. They're going to cap up on C. I guess at this point it doesn't impact their time a huge, huge amount, you know? But it's just adding time. There's Psy going in for the bomb. I mean, there's really not much to say at this point. I mean, is there?
Not really. I mean, unless Apple has something up their sleeve for defense, this is looking very, very grim.
I mean, it's just hard to see Quail Noises potentially. Brulee is going to go down to Yimmy there in Death Hallway. So it looks like they wanted to go for the straight alphabet push, but that's not going to work out for them this time. Maybe another chance to go for D, but posting up in lobby right now is the combo of Quail Noises. So, you know what, though? I got to hand it to Quail Noises. They're still playing the game. You know what I mean? They're not off-classing. They're not switching around. They're not playing like these stupid classes. They're playing the way the meta would dictate. So, you know, it's good sportsmanship, but it's still tough. Smiles actually going to take out Vol there. Was that a drop? I don't believe it was, but Vol is going to die. There goes Kev and Yimmy as well. Only three up right now for two up, actually, I should say, as another one goes down. That's Bubs. If they can take out Rue and May, but May's going to clean up on a couple more frags. Getting in there is Bunny. Should be able to take out Rue. May did go down, so only two up. They gotta commit more bodies onto E, though. They've only got one times one on point. I know they want to keep people forward to choke off those spawns, but finally getting onto the point there is Bunny. And doing a good job so far is Apple. And you gotta think, if it wasn't for that Flub B push for so long, this would actually be a really, really good time. They should be able to cap up on it now. It's just that B push. 10 minutes, 39 seconds. I mean, considering we were at eight and a half minutes, right? After B was capped, it only took him two to go get C and E. So, you know, even if it took him 4 minutes to cap B, it would have been a 6 minute time. But that 8 minutes just absolutely slayed them.
Here's Glider with a pretty sneaky, sticky spot right there. I don't think he's gonna catch anyone. It's right above the Beador. The shutter.
I feel like this would work. I've seen, you know, this trap go down, but this trap would work against other teams. I don't think it's going to work against the team of sixes players, especially with how common it is in sixes. Rue's going to just charge right ahead. Glider not popping up anything, and Rue's going to go forward and put some pressure onto Bunny. Glider's got to be careful. He just managed to get pumped, so... there's something. There's something out of it. Glider's got to be careful. I don't think he just understands fully that Kev can just destroy him in a second. So he did back off a little bit, but he needs to make sure he doesn't get baited out or anything. Pomp is going to get behind the enemy combo here, though. Get ready to get cloaked. And American might actually catch him out just with random spray. Pomp is going to be... looks like caught out here. So not going to get anything done. He tried to go for the sap. Good job there. Teleporting at the sentry, though, is knocked. So that is not going to go down. The Ubers were traded. And this might be... Oh, no. It looked like it would have been successful there for Apple. But they managed to lose a lot of players. And just in terms of their health, good after the Uber. Everything else was looking good. May might go down. 11 health. If someone could just do a little bit more damage, but it looks like that's not going to happen. May should be able to walk out and already back and giving up the B point is Apple. So, I mean, it's.
I feel like it's a mistake for Apple to try and hold C at this point. I mean. With May's, you know, spamming ability, I feel like he can just force him out of E if he wants to.
Right. So. If you give Quail Noises a chance to put some bodies onto E, I really don't think that they have a chance. I'm interested to see how Quail Noises want to play this, though. Do they want to go for the alphabet? Do they think they, you know, just play it safe and trust the fact that you can beat in 11-minute time? Or just play the way that you set out to? It looks like they are going to at least go for C. Kev getting the shot onto to knock. Ubers are traded, but it looks like it's going to be much better in the favor of Quail Noises. Brulee is going to get caught out by Psy. This should be the C point in a second here.
Glider did manage to pick up May on his way down, but we're still four down right now for Apple. It's not looking good.
Yeah, C is gonna go down right here. Respawn's coming in right now for Apple, but actually, I want to take a quick overview too of what's going on. So it looks like right now pushing over through Death Hallway is the combo. Oh, Vol's gonna go down there to Smile. So really good job by Vol there to by Smiles there taking a Vol. It's actually going to reset the push completely here by Quail Noises. They are going to benefit from quick respawn, so it's really on Apple to be near perfect here.
They do need to keep Relay alive right now. If Relay goes down, that's going to be the round. So.
Glider's got to be careful not to go down here as well, because with the combo, it's just like a domino effect. When one falls, the rest probably will. Viper's going to manage to take out May before going down. Yimmy, Rue, Kev, and Bubs all go down for Quail Noises. But look at that. They're already respawned. Vol actually goes down. BFF chasing back to spawn. Fantastic play by him. Already respawned as well. But Brulee is at least going to walk away with some good Uber ad out of that. May goes down to Glider and getting a little sloppy right now, I think, is Quail Noises. So, at once I kind of complimented them for playing the game kind of kind of tight, even though they had an 11-minute time to work with.
You see where Pumpkin's caught out, but he was in a corner and Brûlée was right bumping against him and he didn't even know.
Vipa is gonna, a spy main probably had the tingle feeling, you know?
Yeah.
Vipa does go down, so does Jayden. Vol goes down to Glider, though. Here is the Uber out of Apple, so they're gonna clean up on May. BFF Forever is absolutely being an integral piece of his team. But a
heels
lot
are
of
absolutely
picks.
Awful right now for Apple.
Yeah, and they did lose a bunch of players. Oh. I think that Uber was the right call. They can't second guess what they did. It was just unfortunate. Quillnoise just walk away with the frags, and that is most likely going to be our grand finals here, guys. As as everything gets all messed up on my screen here, times two on the point. May working with that pain train. One player left alive. That is American. And ladies and gentlemen, we have our winners of the UGC Gold Grand Finals and the Season 18 champions, Quillnoises. Wow. I'm actually, you know what? Quillnoises came to play. I mean, you can say what you want, but at the end of the day, they had they came out with a plan, and like I said, although they got a little sloppy at the end, they still, you know, they did what they needed to do, and they just proved their strength with their 11th straight win. So I really gotta hand it to Quillnoises, not just for this game, but for the entire season. A big congratulations to everyone. You know, I know they work really, really hard, and it's not just a team that was here to crush and you know, try to be. I mean, obviously you're gonna try to be the best, but they worked hard, and I really gotta hand it and good job here for Apple as well, getting as far as they did. They're gonna take the second place medal. And not a bad place to be as well. In Season 17, a very different Apple roster also took second place, although not a playoff season. So Mime, what are your thoughts here?
Well, there's always next season. I know both of these teams are moving on to play, and you know, maybe there will be a grudge match, and we'll see Apple get their revenge, maybe.
Kind of brings a little tear to my eye, you know? Just like, you know, these people that I've been casting for so long. And they're going to move on. If I definitely think Quillnoises, if they're going to stick around and have the relatively the same roster, definitely going to fare well in Platt. Apple, probably going to have to do some work and restructuring. You know what, maybe not restructuring. I think consistency is key, and I think a lot of players on Apple will tell you that. That it was just really difficult trying to find the right players, you know, to play every day. But not taking away anything from Quillnoises, absolutely came in, and they're the better team and take the victory. So I don't know, Mime, you got anything else to add here? Or?
I don't really have much. All I have to say is thank you for watching Gold if you've been following the entire season. It's been fun. And, you know, I'm excited to see maybe someone else will cast Gold next season. I don't know.
Yeah, guys, it's been really fantastic. It was a really awesome season. Just kind of... Mime added me at some point in the offseason, was like, hey, you want to cast with me? Or, like, you looking for a co-caster? And I was like, hell yeah, it sucks doing this alone. So, it's been a really awesome season for it with everything, and it breaks my heart. Mime is going back to his actual playing of TF2, but the end of an era here of Season 18 Gold. Definitely, in my book, going to go down as one of the best seasons, at least... probably one of the most hyped up seasons. There's just been a lot of coverage in terms of casting and articles and, you know, I gotta thank Mio for that, and thanks to a lot of the people as well that were putting a lot of effort and work in the off season to you know, really shine some more light on UGC and the Highlander game mode. So it's really awesome, guys, and I mean, thank you so much for joining us on this grand finals and on this journey, on this train that we called life, you know. So before we drop out and you know, say goodbye to this epic season and this awesome cast, anything else, any last words here, Mime, before I kill you for leaving me?
Shout out to the Dust Crew. I know there's a few of them watching, so.
And I would like to shout out Mime. I whenever I couldn't cast or whenever I had things going on, Mime, thank you so much, dude. You know, you made things really successful, and you made the burden a lot easier on myself here. So I really appreciate it, and I appreciate all you guys for coming out and watching and following on this channel and the other channel. And if you are interested to see what's going on next season, you know, definitely ask me. Definitely check out. You know, definitely make announcements on the forums or hit that follow button and find out what's going on. So. You know, and thanks a lot to all the teams that have been so gracious to let us cast. And congratulations once again to Quail Noises. Enjoy that first place badge. It was well deserved. So, you know, you guys are an absolutely epic crew. And I wish you all the best of luck in Plat. But anyway, guys, I will catch you next season. Or, hold on. All-Stars. Mime?
Right. I'll do it.
Alright, we got one more cast under our belt, guys. All-Stars voting is going on the UGC forums right now. All those goodbyes, and it's like whenever you say goodbye, but you start walking in the same direction, right? So, All-Stars voting going on right now in the forums. Check it out, cast your votes, and hopefully we'll be able to schedule everything in the time that we can get a game casted. But anyway, guys, have a great night.